Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. Welcome to your chemistry class of standard 10. Today, I will discuss about a new topics of chemistry, that is electrochemical energy. At first, I will discuss about electrical conductors. Electric conductors, the metallic and non-metallic substances through which electricity can pass are called electric conductors. For example, you know that all metallic substances actually have the electric conductivity. So all metals are metallic conductors, and except one, that is graphite, you know that this is an allotropic form of carbon. Mainly carbon, although it is a non-metal, but it is also a conductor, electric conductor. For this, graphite is a non-metallic electric conductor. This is copper electric wire, and this is also electric wire made of aluminium, and we have seen. So here it is easily understood that metal or metallic wires are generally used to conduct electricity or as electric wire. So what will be the non-conductor? Very easy. The substances through which electricity cannot pass are called electric non-conductors or insulator. This term you have to understand here, insulator, electric non-conductors or insulator. For example, rubber, plastic, glass, etc. So, the substance through which electricity is passed are called electric conductors, and the substance through which electricity cannot be passed are called insulator or non-conductor. Now we will know about classification of electric conductors. Electric conductors mainly two types, electronic conductors and electrolytes. Actually these categories done on the basis of conduction of electricity, medium of conduction of electricity. Then electronic conductors again three types, good conductor, semiconductor and superconductor. And electrolytes, again two types, three types, strong electrolyte, weak electrolyte and non-electrolyte. Today we will know about these types of electric conductors. At first, electronic conductors or metallic conductors. The solid metals or non-metal, that is graphite, which conduct electricity by means of one or more mobile electrons which are present in their atoms are called electronic conductors or metallic conductors. For example, different metals such as copper, aluminium, silver, gold, etc. and non-metal graphite. Students, you know that inside the metal actually which bond is present? Metallic bond. Have you remember metallic bond? Metallic bond. How metallic bond is formed? Actually inside the metal, inside the atoms of that metal, all atoms are carrying valence electrons. And these valence electrons from their valence shell come outside and move freely surrounding their atomic core or positively charged core. So, inside the metallic compound or inside the metal, actually there is present mobile or free electrons. Actually, there is seen free movement of electrons. And these free movement of electrons are responsible for the electric conductivity of metals. And so, here electricity is actually conducted through electrons. For this they are known as electronic conductors. Follow this picture. Here, inside the metal, electrons from valence shell comes out and they are actually freely move. For this, electricity is easily conducted from through these electrons from negative pole to positive pole. So like this way, actually for this reason, for the presence of this free electron, metals can conduct electricity and they are known as electronic conductors. Now, which are good conductor? The metals which can conduct electricity easily, like copper, aluminium, iron, zinc, silver, etc., are called good conductors. That means their electricity conductivity or electric conductivity is high. They can conduct electricity with any resistance. They conduct electricity in high. For this, they are known as good conductor. Semiconductor. There are some materials having some conducting property in between conductors and non-conductors, which are called semiconductors. For example, elements of group 14 of periodic table such as silicon, germanium are known as semiconductors or metalloid. That means among these elements, silicon, germanium, they have the both property, electric conductivity property and electric non-conductivity property. Both property are present. That means they are not good electric conductor as like other metals. They are in middle position between conductors and non-conductors. They are called semiconductor. And another conductor is nowadays it is prepared, that is known as superconductor. Superconductor mainly alloy of metal or oxides of alloy of metals. And why they are said superconductor? Because they conduct electricity without any electric resistance. That means their electric conduction power is super. This type of substance are known as superconductor. For example, niobium 3 germanium. Here, 3 atoms of niobium and 1 atom of germanium mixed. It is actually alloy. You know that alloy means molten mixture of metal. And here, yttrium, barium, copper and oxygen. This is actually alloy oxide. So this type of alloy has been prepared whose conduction power is highest. For this, they are known as superconductor. Now, electrolyte. The melts and aqueous solution of ionic compound and polar covalent compounds which can conduct electricity are called electrolytes. Electrolytes actually solution or melted liquid state of ionic compound or polar covalent compound. This melted ionic compound or solution, aqueous solution of ionic compound or polar covalent compound, they can conduct electricity. And this type of solution for this called electrolyte. Actually, in this melted or aqueous solution of ionic compounds, cations and anions are moved freely, which are responsible for conducting electricity. That means inside this solution or melted substance, free ions are present. Cations or anions, free ions are present, which actually conducts electricity. And electrolysis process is happen due to occur of oxidation or reduction reaction in this solution. So electrolysis actually one reaction, redox reaction, which is proceed using electricity. We will know about this electrolysis reaction in next class. So just here you have to understand, electric conductors are two types, electronic conductor where conductors are conduct electricity using electrons, and electrolytes are conductor where conductors conduct electricity using free ions. I hope you understand. Follow this picture. Here this is an electrolytic cell where molten sodium chloride is kept. So inside the molten sodium chloride there is present sodium ion and chlorine ion, and when we supply electricity from outside, then what will happen? This electricity actually conducted through these free ions, sodium ion and chlorine ions. For this, here we can see this circuit. Here they are connected, but their distance inside the solution, but electricity is passed because this molten sodium chloride is actually can conduct electricity. For this, they are electrolytic conductor. Now, among these electrolytes, some are strong electrolyte, some are weak electrolyte, and some are non-electrolyte. Which are strong electrolyte? The ionic compounds in aqueous solution which ionize about to 70 to 100% are called strong electrolytes. That means the solution or melted substance of ionic compounds in which ions are ionized in 70 to 100%. That means they are ionized in great amount. So when they are ionized 70 to 100%, that means inside that electrolytes, the presence of free ions will be high. The amount of presence of free ions is more. For this, they can conduct electricity more. For this, they are known as strong electrolyte. Understood, my dear students? When in an electrolytes, the amount of ions will be more, then they can conduct more electricity. So strong electrolytes are those electrolytes which ionized 70 to 100%. For example, sodium chloride. We know that in aqueous solution of sodium chloride or melted state of sodium chloride, here sodium chloride is a strong ionic compound. For this, they ionized 100%. Totally they are present in ionized condition. Potassium chloride, similarly potassium chloride, then hydrogen chloride. Hydrogen chloride is a covalent compound, but polar covalent compound. And polar covalent compound and their ionization capacity is also high. For this, these substances are known as strong electrolyte. Again, what is weak electrolyte? The compounds which ionize in aqueous solution about very less amount, that is 1 to 10% are called weak electrolytes. For example, 0.1 molar acetic acid. Acetic acid is a organic acid, and we know that all organic acids are weak acid. Why weak acid? Because they are ionized in a very less amount. Most of the inside the aqueous solution, they are ionized in acetate ion and hydrogen ion in very less amount, only 1 to 10%, and rest of 90% actually they are remain an acetic acid, but only 1 to 10% they are remain as acetate ion and hydrogen ion. For this, they are actually weak electrolyte, and for this they can conduct electricity in very less amount. They are not good conductors. And non-electrolyte, the compounds do not ionize in aqueous solution or cannot conduct electricity. In a word, we can say the aqueous solution which cannot conduct or which are not allowed to pass electricity are called non-electrolytes. For example, glucose solution, sucrose solution, alcohol or liquid hydrocarbons, they are not allowed to pass electricity through inside them. So for this they are known as non-electrolyte. Now easily you can differ between metallic conductor and electrolytic conductor. Metallic conductor, here electricity is conducted due to the flow of electrons, and in electrolytic conductor electricity is conducted due to the flow of ions. It involves no change in chemical properties, only physical change occurs. That means here actually no chemical reactions occur, just inside the metal electricity is conducted. But in electrolytic conductors chemical reactions occur, for this chemical change occurs, because here we have seen when we use an electrolyte, and after electrolysis process we will see in next class there is produced different elements, constituent elements. For example, from sodium chloride electrolytes, in the next time we will get sodium metal or oxygen gas and chlorine gas. So here they are totally different from sodium chloride. For this their chemical change occur. It does not involve transfer of matter. Yes, matter is not transferred here. It involves transfer of matter in the form of ions. Now conductivity decreases with increase in temperature. That means if we increase temperature of metallic conductor, then it electric conductivity is decreases, because in that time heat conduction is increases. But conductivity increases with increase in temperature in case of electrolytic conductor, because you know that when you increase temperature of any solution, then the kinetic energy of molecules inside the solution will be increased. For this their electric conductivity is also increased. So like this way you can differ between metallic conductor and electrolytic conductor. Now my dear students, we will know about electrochemical cell. Actually electrochemical cell we can define like this way: a single arrangement of two electrodes in one or two electrolytes which converts chemical energy into electrical energy or electrical energy into chemical energy. That means electrochemical cell actually are arrangement where electrodes are used, electrolytes are used, and using this arrangement there is actually conversion occur, either chemical energy to electrical energy or electrical energy to chemical energy. We will know about this electrochemical cell in next classes. Here just I have shown, just I want to introduce today with the electrochemical cell. For this I have kept a lesson, little learning here. So this is electrochemical cell, and it is two types: galvanic cells and electrolytic cell. For example, this is galvanic cell. Follow here this zinc sulfate solution and copper sulfate solution, these are electrolytes. So two electrolytes are used, and this metallic bar, follow here, zinc bar, copper bar, these two bar are known as electrodes. I have said in definition they are used arrangement, single arrangement of two electrodes and electrolytes, one electrolyte or two electrolytes. Here two electrolytes are used, and these electrodes are used for conducting electricity. For conducting electricity there is used metallic bar. So this arrangement is known as, this is a electrochemical cell, and its special it is known as galvanic cell, where chemical energy is converted into electrical energy due to oxidation reduction reaction. Here actually redox reaction occurs, and after redox reaction the resulting is produced to electricity. Here the presence of this voltmeter actually represents the production of electricity. And follow this picture, this is electrolytic cell, where single electrolyte, one electrolyte is used. Follow here, solution of electrolyte, one electrolyte is used, but also there is two electrodes. And here, what is the difference between galvanic cell and electrolytic cell? Here follow, in galvanic cell we have seen chemical energy is converted into electrical energy, because from chemical reaction electricity is produced. And here from outside, this is the source of electricity, battery. When we connect the two electrodes with the battery, then electricity should be supplied inside the circuit. And due to supplying electricity, here this electrolyte, actually inside the electrolyte, chemical reaction will occur. So here electric energy is converted into chemical energy. So we will know about this electrolytic cell and galvanic cell in next classes, no problem. Just today you have to read about the conductors, electric conductors, types of electric conductors, etc. So today up to this, in next class, inshallah, we will know more about this electrochemical cells. Goodbye today.